We now officially know who's going to be versing who in the conference finals. And let me tell you, it's some great matchups. And whoever wins the series goes on to the NBA finals. So I'll be talking about who's most likely to gonna win and what the series is gonna look like and who's versing who and other stuff. So just wanna say Chiggles in. Now, the predictions that I make in this video might not be right because we've seen a lot of lopsided series, like the Lakers vs. Warriors. I expected the Warriors to at least take it to a Game 7 or win it all, and quicker, like a Game 6. And also, we saw my Milwaukee Bucks get eliminated. And now they've fired the head coach because of this. And we saw the Phoenix Suns get eliminated over the Denver Nuggets. I mean, it was a pretty harsh series, but to have KD, D-Book, Chris Paul, and Jante Ayton, which, well, wasn't really playing the best. It's a stacked squad. You're expected to do much better than what they did. And for Warriors' case, Klay needed to knock down some more shots, I think. And Jordan Poole shouldn't have shot the 28-footer from more or less the logo range. And then in a couple of those games, some of the younger bench players kind of got into it and they really led the fourth quarter. In the Warriors season against the Lakers, but the Lakers also had their young players which could play in the fourth quarter too, so it ended up going to the Lakers as game one was a clear win for the Lakers, and because of the Jordan Poole shot, and I think from that Jordan Poole shot, the Warriors just got, let's just say, brung down by that, because they knew they could have won that game, but one of the teammates just decided to chuck up bad shot when there were open guys in the corner, and it's from 28 feet, you could at least dribble it up to the 3-point line. It's kind of ridiculous, but we are here to talk about the playoffs. So my predictions are that the Lakers do beat the Denver Nuggets. See, the only reason why is, so, as a center position, we have the matchup of Anthony Davis and Nikola Jokic. See, this is kind of tough to say, but I think AD is just a stronger player. He can get more rebounds. I mean, I'm pretty sure Nikola has the high over, but he won't be able to. Nikola is very skinny and weak compared to other centers like Joel Embiid, which just won the MVP over him. And he couldn't hold up against someone like AD, so I reckon AD will win that. But at the power forward, we have Aaron Gordon versus LeBron. And I think we all know how that goes. I'll pick LeBron. Now at the small forward, it's chopping, changing for the Denver Nuggets. But for the Lakers, they have a good role player, Rui Hachimura. And I don't know at the moment who he would verse. Most likely Michael Porter Jr. he'll verse in that starting lineup. And that will be one of the toughest spots. I say the Denver Nuggets would win that position. But at the shooting guard, you have Dennis Schroeder versus KCP. I think Dennis Schroeder, well, it's a tough battle, but I just say Dennis Schroeder's on top. Then you have D'Lo versus Jamal Murray. That's what I most want to see. So, yeah. Because that will be a tough matchup. I need D'Lo's really warm in that mid-range this playoffs, and Jamal's red hot, dunking the ball, shooting the ball. D'Lo, I mean, he's pretty good on D. Jamal's pretty good on D, so it's going to be a tough matchup. And honestly, I don't think I can pick who's going to come on top on that one. But just because of the LeBron and AD situation, I have the Lakers winning that series. I don't know. I wouldn't say in how much games they would do it in. Maybe a game six, game seven. I don't expect it to go to when they win in a game five or four. But for the Miami Heat versus Boston Celtics situation, that's kind of hard to predict because no one knows how long Jimmy Butler can carry the Miami Heat. I mean, like, other guys have to step up. Bam has to step up. Tyler Herro has to step up. Kyle Lowry has to step up. You know, all those guys have to step up, and Jimmy Butler's absolutely carrying the team. I mean, he made it for the first round against Giannis and carried. Absolutely carried. And then versus the Knicks, he carried again. He just carried. I mean, he had like 56 against the Milwaukee Bucks. Like, that's the definition of carrying your team. And no one knows how long he can carry the Miami Heat, sorry. So we saw in 2020 he went against LeBron in the finals, but can he actually make it that far again? I reckon the Miami Heat will be eliminated. I don't expect Jimmy Butler to be carrying the team this long. He's going to get tired. He's going to be annoyed because no one's stepping up. I mean, Bam is an amazing player, don't get me wrong, but he just doesn't fit next to Jimmy Butler right now. And Tyler Herro just needs to step up for those big shots and not be scared of a ball. And I mean, their bench is not really the best, so they're gonna probably play their starters a lot. And they're gonna get quite tired. So I have the Heat winning that. So that means Boston winning that, sorry. So that's the Boston versus Lakers. And then in that finals, I think it will be one of the most fantastic finals we've seen since, I don't know, Cavs versus Warriors. Because, I mean, they both have 17 championships each franchise. And, I mean, in that final, they will be fighting for 18 to go on top of the NBA with the most championships. And I don't want to say who's winning that because LeBron, Jason Tatum, I mean, LeBron absolutely hates the Boston fans for reasons I won't get into. But, and then Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown have been playing amazing, but I'm just not gonna say. You never know. AD could be injured, and it could be Boston versus Nuggets. But I'm predicting the finals will be Boston versus Lakers. So with that, I would like to say, Chiggles out.